We're back at the Artistry and Wood Show here for Woodcraft, and this woodworking adventure takes us a little bit more past the normal story. It takes us past the Artistry and Wood Show into the jungles of Vietnam. I've got David Boone here, who served with part of the 9th Division, but really didn't start that way. Now, Dave, you started out really in transportation. Tell us about that.
I was in transportation, and when I went to Vietnam, because of the Tet Offensive, I was put into the 9th Infantry, and so that was a rude awakening for me. So I went into the Delta. The boat I was supposed to run for ship-to-shore work was made a gunboat and stayed in there 9 months.
Now, originally, you know, being part of just transportation, you really weren't trained for combat. You got there and you were just stuck right in the middle of it, and all of a sudden you guys were in there fighting and using the boat that they had built to get these guys out of there for the wounded and getting them back to safety and get all sewed up.
Yeah, and the boats had, we didn't have any living quarters. That was we just lived like wild animals, kind of. We took some boards and made 3 sides to a little shack, and then put some tin on top to keep the rain off. And so that's where I lived for 9 months, and it wasn't fun.
You served in this, ended up serving in the 9th for 2 years. You had a wife back home, you wanted to get home, so you did your service, and you got drafted at quite a late age, 27, which is kind of unheard of back then.
Yeah, I was the same age as the company commander. Company commander was 27, and I was too, so he asked me why I come in the Army so late, and I told him the MPs come and got me.
There you go. Now, it leads us to this story here about this carving. This is obviously a memoriam to what you have gone through there, and you've seen a lot of things that you wish you didn't see. But tell us about the carving. You've got a couple of pieces of basswood carved here, and buckeye.
Yeah, I didn't have enough real good basswood to do the carving, and when I got started, I ran out of the good basswood and had to use some basswood that was burnt up in a kiln almost, and then I ran out of it. And I happen to have some buckeye, which is pretty good carving wood. And so really, I was just down on the floor hunting wood to put this thing together.
Now, this took you, you said, about 5 weeks to put together. In fact, you just got it finished to get it into this show.
Right. It took a long time. I had to do a lot of figuring how each guy was going to stay balanced and how they were all going to tie together. So it was trying. It was.
Now, again, it did take you 5 weeks to put this together. What kind of finish did you use?
I just used a stain finish that I got at Woodcraft.
Okay. And your local store that you frequent is
down in just out of Johnson City, Tennessee.
So you've got about an hour to hour and a half drive from North Carolina.
Yeah, and I scoot over the mountain and down there, and the guys have got everything you need right there. So, and it's. When you walk in, they know you, and it's like we old friends getting together, so it's fun.
Well, David, we thank you for your patronage to Woodcraft, but more importantly, we thank you for your service to this country, and thank you for what you have done for us.
Thank you.
We appreciate what you've done. You have one little story about a buckeye that kept you safe over there, and tell us about that with the other guy you were serving with.
Yeah, one of my best friends, we called him Doc. Everybody had a nickname, and I pulled a buckeye out of my pocket, and he said, "What is that?" And I said, "It's a buckeye." He said, "Where did you get a buckeye in Vietnam?" And I said, "Well, my grandfather gave me 15 and said they were lucky for me to keep one in my pocket." So Doc just, he thought that was the craziest thing he'd ever seen. So he was laughing and making fun of me. About 2 days later, we got into a pretty bad firefight, and it was dark, and I heard Doc hollering, and I thought, oh me, Doc's wounded. I hollered back, and I told him where I was. Well, he slid in beside me, and I said, "Doc, are you hurt?" And he said, no, I'm not hurt. He said, "Give me one of those buckeyes."
So he was hollering for a buckeye for more safety.
Yeah.
See, he wanted that protection.
I said, "Well, I'll get you one, but I'm not hunting it right now."
Yeah. Well, did it guarantee your safety back here,
Doc,
obviously?
And I both, when I've talked to him on the phone when he come home.
Yeah.
And Doc lives in Arkansas.
Right.
And yeah, he got home safe, and he was quite a fella. He and I hit it off. Doc already had the Bronze Star when I got over there, so he was quite a fella.
Now, you've got a lot of this commentary and story about what you've gone through in your book. Tell us about Sing Me Back Home by David Boone.
You know, the boys that went to Vietnam got such a bad rap at home. They were just looked down upon and bad things said about them. And we were just American boys that were drafted and went to war, just did what our country said to do. And so I wanted my grandchildren to understand that we were the good guys and that we weren't over there just trying to kill everything that walked. And I know that we got a lot of folks hurt in areas where we were afraid if we fired back, we would hurt civilians.
But you also ended up saving a lot of the enemy because they said they were civilians, so you were patching them up alongside American boys.
That happened a lot because we had a medic with us. And all of a sudden, there'd be a couple of kids come out of the jungle, and they'd be carrying a guy, and he's wounded, and, oh, he's no VC, and we'd wind up doctoring a lot of the guys that we'd just been fighting, so it was crazy.
So in the book, you've documented that for remembrance, so yeah. No one really forgets what's going on. And tell us specifically about the guitar. You put a lot of soul searching back into the guys and a lot of good feelings to keep the company together with that guitar.
The guitar was probably the best soldier in the outfit. I was trying to get into music, and I was wanting to go to Nashville, and I'd written a lot of songs. I did go to Nashville.
Prior to going to Vietnam.
Yeah, prior to go to Vietnam. And I just knew I would finally get a career in music.
Right.
Well, at 27, I'm in Vietnam singing for the boys over there.
Right.
But I found this old guitar. It's an old 12-string guitar in a village in Vietnam outside of Vang Tau.
Okay.
And I talked him out of it and paid him. I forget now what it cost. But anyway, I paid him. And the guitar, at night when we could, we gang around and sing and Sing Me Back Home. I don't know how many times I heard that. Say, David, get your guitar and sing us back home. So that's why I named it Sing Me Back Home. And and the old song, I Want to Go Home by Bobby Blair, I bet I've sung it a million times. So, but the guitar really, it was just like an old friend. And but those boys looked after my guitar.
It touched their hearts, and obviously it brought you guys together.
Yes, it did. Yes, it did.
David, thank you once more for
everything
you have done for this country.
Thank you.
Thanks for the remembrance in this piece. And you did win first place in the category,
best of carving,
wood carving.
Yeah.
So congratulations for that as well.
All right.
You've done
thank
well.
You
and
said.
this is the first time.
No. This is the first time I've been here in a couple of years.
Okay.
Yeah. I had a little bit problem with cancer last year, so I didn't get to come. And before that, I had a shoulder replacement. So, but now, good
you're
Lord.
You're back and you're carving.
Yes.
Well, keep coming into Woodcraft and keep coming back to the show. We'll look for you time and time again.
Woodcraft keeps me going.
All right. We appreciate that.
Yes, sir.
Thank you so
yes,
much.
Sir.
We'll have more from the Artistry and Wood Show, so we'll be right back. Take care. Thanks, David.
Take me away and turn back the years and say